All we do is put ourselves into little boxes created by society. This is how we must be. This is how we must behave. People will look at you. Haw.
जब वो सवाल आता है ना कि आप कैसे confident हो, तो मैं confident बिल्कुल नहीं हूँ. It's just that I'm out there and I'm sharing what is my experience.
किसी दूसरे इंसान को it's almost as if उसकी right है उसको ये remind करना कि you know तू मोटी है, तू मोटा है, तू weight, तुझे weight कम करना चाहिए.
Welcome to Sisterhood with me, Sherry Chopra. Today, we're discussing the very critical issue of body shaming, whether it's about fat shaming, skinny shaming, or any other kind of shaming when it comes to feeling proud, out, loud and about your body. How do women who are constantly criticized for their bodies feel? What do they go through? What kind of psychological changes do they anticipate will happen to them when they grow up if they've been raised on a diet of staying skinny, thin, and staying friendly to society's needs? Today on Sisterhood, we're going to break this down with women who have been talking about the body positivity narrative. Pooja Bedi has launched Happy Soul, a platform that she believes will bring holistic nourishment and wellness to women. But her own journey with staying fit at an older age, how has that been perceived? Through the lens of ageism, through the lens of gender, and of course, through the lens of being somebody who couldn't care what people felt when she decided to roam around in a bikini or talk about sexual wellness along with wellness. Tell me something, as an individual, I've always viewed you as a very gutsy woman, and I think a lot of other women have too. As a woman who believes in doing what she believes is right and is her own way.
All we do is put ourselves into little boxes created by society. This is how we must be. This is how we must behave. People will look at you. Haw. People will point a finger. Haw. Oh, who cares? I want to go out and have fun. They're going to say haw, they're going to say haw anyway. But how does their haw change my life? It doesn't.
Women are getting comfortable with their bodies. Back when you were coming on screen, in what would then define the society would say skimpy clothes, which I think is par for the course today. How difficult was it to be yourself in the prying eyes of society?
Well, you know, my mother used to say, if the world laughs at you, laugh right back. It's as funny as you are. So I grew up with this very healthy irreverence, I would say, and this firm belief that it was my life and I was going to definitely lead it on my own terms. As long as I wasn't breaking the law, it was all okay. I had a really good body and I was happy to flaunt it. For me, if people turned around and said, "Haw, dekho kaise kapde pehnti hai," I remember what my mom taught me when I was very young and she streaked on the breech. And at that point of time, because your friends come say, "Haw, my mummy said your mummy ran naked on the beach." And you turn around and I came home and I said, "Mama, you're so shocking." They said, "You were shocking." She said, "Pooja, can you define shocking?" I said, "You know, shocking. Shocking is shocking. Mama, you're shocking." They said, "You're shocking." So she said, "All right, let's talk about shocking. There's a woman in some Middle Eastern country that cannot show her wrist. And she's flogged if she even shows her wrist. That woman looks at a very traditional Indian woman in a burqa and says, how shocking. Her wrist is showing while she's cooking her food. And men are seeing her cooking the food and her wrist is showing. That woman says, hello, how can you call me shocking? At least my face is covered. Shocking are those women who uncovered their faces. Pura dunya ko chehre dikha rahe hain. That woman turns and says, hello, at least my head is covered, right? Shocking are those women who are going out there wearing modern clothes. They're wearing jeans. That's shocking. The girl in the jeans turns around and says, hello, at least my skin is covered. What about those girls who are showing flesh in their mini skirts? That's bloody shocking. The girl in the mini skirt says, hello, at least I've got my private parts covered. What about people like who are roaming around in bikinis on the beach? You know, and they're like, hello, I may be wearing bikini, but at least I'm covering the very little bare essentials. Shocking is Pratima Bedi, who's critiqued without anything else. So she says, now, this has gone a full circle and it's come back to me, darling. Ask me, what do I think is shocking? I think that woman in a Middle Eastern country who has absolutely no freedom and is flogged for her issue, I think that is shocking. So we can always be in judgment of people. We can always turn around and point a finger and feel superior in our own little way. But the fact is, and moral in our own little way. But morality is so subjective. And today, if back then the vamps were wearing bikinis and today the heroines are wearing bikinis, it's because our perspective and our attitude and our empowerment levels have changed so dramatically in our country.
It's one thing to have people judge you. It's quite another when you judge yourself and have self-doubt.
Absolutely. But where does that doubt come from? where does that doubt come from?
It's where we are.
So once you realize that your limitations lie in your mind, as I was saying earlier, you learn to tap into your subconscious mind and deprogram all these limiting belief systems that are actually causing you guilt, shame, self-doubt, a lack of self-love. Dusro ka socho, khud ka mat socho. You know, khud garz ho to magar khud ka sochti ho. You know, that sort of attitude. So you never want to go to the gym yourself because that time could be used to help others. You never want to actually pamper yourself because that money could be used to do something for someone else. So all these limiting belief systems that make you feel you are invalid, unimportant, and that your entire life is only for service of others, which is so untrue because you came down to this planet to have your own beautiful journey, right? And of course, it's wonderful to go out there and help others, and you should, but only when your well is full should others drink from it.
Most women are not as confident as you are because they're either getting fat shamed or skinny shamed or skin color shamed or clothes shamed or whatever else, you know, sort of shaming around them. As somebody who did deal with the whore of society, what would you say they need to do to be more comfortable in their skin?
Okay, firstly, if somebody calls you an elephant, that doesn't make you one. So firstly, you have to understand which part of you allows others to make you feel a certain way. It becomes a belief in your subconscious or conscious mind that you are that. Okay, firstly. Secondly, when you look around and you see that who you consider ugly people, beauty is in the eyes of the beholder, right? So some people you will look at and say, they are so ugly, but somebody else will say, no, my God, that person is so beautiful. Sit and analyze how you sit and interpret others and how you judge others too, because we are all in equal fault. And that's why if you didn't judge others, you give a damn what others think of you.
According to one study, those who were exposed to weight bias and discrimination had higher chances to turn obese and most certainly put on weight. The question is, why are we obsessed with skinny shaming or fat shaming, and why don't we let people be just as comfortable as they'd like to be in their own bodies? Does fat shaming really make people lose weight? Why do many people think that fat shaming is cool and might actually encourage others to lose weight and get back into shape, whatever shape that might be? Comedian Supriya Joshi, an award-winning comedian who's been talking about body positivity on many social platforms and how. Also on the show is Neelakshi, who's a teacher in a college. She's a body positivity influencer and often talks about being comfortable in one's own skin. Supriya, what is fat shaming and how do we recognize? Isse hum kaise dekh sakte hain?
In my definition, fat shaming is just a means to put a person down on the basis of what they physically look like. And yeah, it can be manifested in many ways, from verbally communicating it. Sometimes your own family members, they tell you, you know, that something's wrong in your body. And if you're somebody who is on the internet, then practically any stranger can say whatever they wish to say.
Neelakshi, is there any signs over there? How do people recognize it?
When people go on and, you know, say things like "अच्छा बेटा कम खा ले, ये you know शादी कैसे होएगी, थोड़ा सा ध्यान रखा कर, तू बहुत सुंदर है, तू बहुत प्यारी है, but you know almost you know it comes from the closest ones and बहुत ही sugar coat होके आता है. So I think that is where we want to start to recognize them. It starts at a very early age, I feel. It's not even just the family members or people on the internet, but चलते फिरते अगर आप road पे हैं, it almost gives somebody have this pre-opinion on your body. Ki, haan bhai, hum isko ek advice de.
The intent is to make you thin and fit, etc. But jab wo weight bias ki conversation shuru hoti hai, actually its impact is exactly the opposite. So Supriya, iske psychological effects zyada hain, jiske baare mein hum kam baat karte hain.
It feels like ki, if there's somebody overweight or somebody who's big in size, kisi dusre insaan ko, it's almost as if uski right hai usko ye remind karna ki, you know, tu moti hai, tu mota hai, tu weight, tujhe weight kam karna chahiye, falana dhimkana dhimkana. Jo bhi iske tumhare intentions jo bhi ho kisi insaan ko ye batane ka, but you don't know what the actual psychological implications of that can be. Motapa feel karna ya apne weight ke bare mein insecurity hona sirf mote logon tak seemit nahi hai. Because some even thin people sometimes feel, you know, that there's something wrong in their body or they've gained weight and they don't look attractive, la 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 la. So when you choose those words or when you choose a certain tone to speak to a person who is overweight or whatever, jaise bhi aapko unse baat karna hai, uska psychological kai tarike se aa sakta hai, you know. It can lead to, of course, depression. It can lead to feelings of suicidal feelings. it can lead to eating disorders, body dysmorphia also. You will never end up feeling you're perfect. Because वो perfection है ही नहीं.
आपके साथ किस तरह ये हुआ? In the sense that when you were growing up, या आप जब अब now you're a body positivity influencer, did you sometimes feel a sense of self-doubt that I don't want, I'm not happy with my body? Or at what point did you get happy with your body?
Honestly, Shelly, it's been like a work in progress every day. It's not something that has happened. You know, even when I am on social media arch and, you know, I project to be all of this confident woman. And I think this is a conversation that even me and Supriya have had out loud with our audience and even with ourselves. Ki maybe you, jab wo sawal aata hai na ki aap kaise confident ho, so main confident bilkul nahi hu. It's just that I'm out there and I'm sharing what is my experience. Wo doctor engineer wala to tha hi nahi. Mere saath to ye tha ki padhai wadhai sab theek hai. बट वेट तुम्हारा एक इतना बड़ा क्राइटेरिया है दैट यू नो बेटा तू सब चीज में बहुत अच्छी है बट वेट कम कर ले. माय पेरेंट्स आर लाइक माय बेस्ट फ्रेंड्स बट द वे दैट दे गेट टू मी इवन नाउ यू कैन बी ऑन द फ्रंट पेज एंड माय मॉम स्टिल बी लाइक बट ये तो ठीक है बट अब तू थोड़ा सा वेट लॉस कर लाइक दैट इज यू नो इट इज नेवर कम्प्लीट फॉर मी. And that, I think, started from a very younger age. That thought, you know, just lingers around. So I don't know, like, where do people stop? Because even today, I feel like I'm not going to be good enough. Whatever I achieve, whatever I do.
And Supriya, did you have that? Ek to na, some often we think about this whole concept of shaming as one where hume self-doubt hota hai. Tabhi hum logon ko koi shame kar paata hai, right?
Look, we are all born thinking we are perfect until somebody says that you're not, right? So this isn't something that is instilled into us at birth. At birth, we don't know any different. So it's when society points out to you ki, you know, tum different ho, tum perfect nahi ho, tum imperfect ho, tum worth it nahi ho, la 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 la. Yeah. And yeah, it really took so much for me to get out of that extreme self-hatred. You know, my journey towards liking myself began with body positivity. But now I think of myself as body neutral and I just want to do the best for my body. But I know my worth is not dependent on what I look like. It depends on the things I do.
Why is it important for us to use digital tools and other platforms to talk much more about being comfortable in our own body?
So body positivity is honestly a movement that I saw starting out in West. And I was like, oh, you can achieve it. How are they so confident? How are they liking themselves? So that's how it started out of curiosity. And then I was like, yeah, you can basically love yourself at any size. But इंडिया में ऑब्वियसली काफी ज्यादा ये नोशन है कि यहाँ सिर्फ मोटे लोग हैं और वो प्रमोट करेंगे बॉडी पॉजिटिविटी विच इज बेसिकली टू लव योर ओन फैट सेल्फ. दिस इज यूज्ड बाय एज अ कवरेज एज अ शेड फॉर फैट वुमेन टू डिस्क्राइब देमसेल्फ. द आइडिया इज आई एम गोइंग टू लव माई सेल्फ एट एनी शेप एट एनी साइज हाउएवर आई एम. आई थिंक करेक्ट मी इफ आई एम रॉन्ग सुप्रिया बट विद बॉडी न्यूट्रैलिटी द आइडिया इज की whatever I am, I'm going to be okay about it. I'm going to, you know, try my best to work on it, to like be in the best of shape, but I'm not going to hate, project that hate towards my body or the love.
Body neutrality is basically not focusing on your body as something that you have to be either proud of or ashamed of. I also agree with you ki body positivity ki definition bahut kharab ho gayi hai. You know, like people don't know what it means. Yes, I think every person who wants to start not hating themselves starts with body positivity because it's great. I want to love myself. I want to love my body. But eventually when you read more, when you understand more and you go in depths of movements and stuff, I found body neutrality as something that works for me because I think I'm able to nourish my soul as well as my body.
There's fat shaming on one side, there's skinny shaming on the other. The weight loss market around the world is close to $100 billion. With that kind of money riding on it, loads and loads of women around the world are taking up diets, crash diets that are impacting their health. In fact, the French government has come up with a ruling that says no size zero woman should be allowed to walk the ramp. As per the new French laws, they have to come up with a doctor's certificate saying as models they are healthy. This, of course, is being viewed by many models as a way of skinny shaming for those who have had no reason to lose their weight intentionally but have always been thin. In fact, a large population in India is currently looking out for ways on how one can put on weight. Mahima Gupta, who's a victim of skinny shaming, from the She the People team, talks about the various psychological factors at play that impact mental health of those who are stuck being so thin that they're shamed for it.
There is a very real and growing problem of skinny shaming. People are often stuck with situations where they are thin and they are ashamed for being that. लोगों को लगता है कि skinny होना या पतला होना एक privilege होता है, but it's definitely not. This skinny shaming started to me when I was in 7th class. तब मैं अपनी क्लास में सबसे पतली थी. My weight at that time was around 30 kgs. Even today, it is only 40 kgs. I often get to hear things like, तेरी स्किन का है यार, तू तो सिर्फ हड्डी का ढांचा है. नाचिस की तीरी. जिम में पत्थर रख के चला कर. हवा चलेगी तो तू उड़ जाएगी. Even आज सुबह ही जब मैं घर से बाहर गई, then गली की आंटी ने मुझे देख के बोला, ये देखो इसे काकड़ी सी. तेरी मम्मी तुझे कुछ खाने को नहीं देती क्या? Whenever I work out or go for an evening walk, मुझे बोला जाता है, इतना चलेगी तो गायब हो जाएगी. तुम इतनी पतली हो, वर्कआउट की क्या जरूरत? ये तो मोटे लोग करते हैं. तुम जैसे लोग वॉक करेंगे तो हम कहाँ जाएंगे? और पतली होके कहाँ जाओगी? अरे तुम्हें कोई बीमारी है क्या? इतनी घिसते क्यों जा रही हो? तेरे कपड़े तो ऐसे लगते हैं जैसे हैंगर पे किसी ने कपड़ा डाल रखा हो. ऑल दीज कमेंट्स आर रूड. जितना गलत फैट शेमिंग होता है उतना ही गलत स्किनी शेमिंग भी होता है. बिकॉज ऑफ दिस शेमिंग एक टाइम ऐसा भी आया था जब आई लॉस्ट ऑल माय सेल्फ कॉन्फिडेंस एंड मुझे घर से निकलते हुए भी डर लगता था. ऐसा लगता है जैसे आई एम नॉट फिट इनफ एंड सच में लोगों की बातें मुझे बहुत बॉदर करने लगी थी. इवन तब तो आई स्टार्टेड टेकिंग मेडिसिन टू लुक फैट. इट रियली शैटर्ड मी फ्रॉम इनसाइड. इन सब बेकार के कमेंट्स ने एक्चुअली मुझे रियलाइज कराया दैट अ वुमन इज नेवर इनफ अकॉर्डिंग टू द सोसाइटी. या तो हम ज्यादा पतले होते हैं या ज्यादा मोटे. वी आर नेवर ओके एंड दैट्स वन ऑफ द मेन रीजंस व्हाई मेनी फीमेल्स हेट देयर बॉडी या फिर दे आर नेवर कंफर्टेबल विद देयर स्किन. वन थिंग दैट आई रियली वॉन्ट यू ऑल टू रिमेंबर इज दैट बॉडी पॉजिटिविटी शुड बी फॉर ऑल बॉडी टाइप्स.
Let's also put the piece of nutrition in this entire conversation. If the idea eventually is to be fit, yet be proud of our bodies, then why do we use skinny shaming or fat shaming as a way to think that we might be going towards a better nourished, a better fit body? Also on the show is Nidhi Kamal, who's a food scientist and looks at how nourishment needs to be not entertainment, not the satisfaction of your hunger, but much more than that. You know, we're trying to break down what are the issues when it comes to body shaming and how women truly need to look at this issue holistically from a health standpoint, not yes. the society's point alone. So let's first talk about crash diets. There's an obsession with them.
Yeah. The obsession stems in the idea that we get attached to the numbers. Primarily being weight. Usually happens that, you know, somebody would always come back and say, can I just go on a juice detox? I'm going to quickly lose some weight on the scale and, you know, I'm stuck. And to that, usually my response is like, what exactly are you aiming for? Is that a number on the scale that is a reflection of, you know, your health status? Like, why is this the obsession about number? And I feel that the obsession is not even about looks. The number is so important.
But why do you think the number is important? I mean, is it because pop culture talks about size zero diets and all that stuff? What is it about?
As a human being, we all want to measure things. Unless you can measure it, it doesn't exist, right? If you can measure it, you can improve it. That's the mindset, right? But I think it gets messed up in the fact that generally, since we are very young, it's conditioned into us that something that somebody who's very, very thin is very, very attractive. And a direct correlation of that has been what we've seen in magazines for so long. Thank God for inclusivity that now it's okay to see somebody in a different size other than zero being portrayed as a model. Thankfully now, you know, the mannequins are also in different sizes. So the narrative is changing. But the conditioning so far has been so strong that it's very difficult for anyone to break that subconscious pattern of thin being healthy.
when this happens to people, which I think it happens to a lot of us in many times in our lives, when we're uncomfortable with ourselves or we are just, you know, giving up on ourselves, what should they be thinking of when it comes to food? I mean, like, you know, we think of all kinds of meals.
Food is not punishment and food is not entertainment, it is nourishment. So you always have to remember that. If you're eating, there's something on your plate, it's not giving you nourishment, it's not food. If it's giving you entertainment, it's not food. If you are seeking punishment from it, if it's a diet that you have to be a certain way, it's not food either, because the emotion attached with that food is not good. So we have to look at food as nourishment.
You know, one of the issues that we're constantly trying to break down in our conversations here at Sisterhood, at She the People, is that being fat, there's nothing wrong. Being thin, there's nothing wrong. As long as one is comfortable with one's body. Where do you think it started seeping in, this whole conversation that being fat is unhealthy, when that needn't be the case?
Obviously, one very big factor here is the fact that zero size has always been glamorized. So anything which was not zero was always considered to be not okay. Another thing is, clinically, if you look at it, an increased weight definitely puts a lot of pressure on all your organs. So I will not say that being overweight is healthy. It is not. And another thing is that health doesn't stop at just the size or just the parameters. If your blood profile is great, if you're at a healthy muscle mass, but mentally you're not okay, that means you're not okay. So I think health also needs to be defined in a larger premise than just being what is the weight and what is the size.
So with all those perspectives, it's a wrap on this episode of Body Shaming, but it's truly important ki hum apni body ko kaise dekhte hain aur uske bare mein kya sochte hain. What can we do to lift our own confidence about ourselves? To begin with, start being proud of what we have and work on our body the way we find it comfortable, instead of going by society's existing beauty standards or fitness standards to put ourselves through what could be unhealthy ways of living, and most importantly, a complete dispelling of our own confidence and our abilities to be able to stay in control of who we are and how we want our life to be. So stay tuned to the She the People YouTube channel. Click on that bell icon to subscribe to us, and we look forward to keep at it, bringing new issues, new elements, new discussions, new faces, new voices to discuss the world that is shaping right before us.